Hey, this is Lara and Good News Ministry. I just got into the car and the past few days have been really, really rough. And one of the hugest blessings about studying the Bible every day of my life, no matter what, the commitment I made years ago, is that God, by His Holy Spirit, will bring to my remembrance scriptures. And He just brought to my remembrance the scripture, "I am with you always, even to the end of time." And my friend, when we turn from our sins and believe in the death and resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ, that He died to pay our sin penalty and was raised from the dead, and we believe in Him as Lord, turning our hearts and lives over to God and His ways as He teaches in the Bible, we are forgiven, and we are given the promise of everlasting life with Him instead of forever apart from Him in eternal torment in hell in the lake of fire. We enter into a forever relationship with Christ, a deeply intimate personal relationship, and we grow over time. And I am right now going through one of the hardest things I've ever gone through in my life. I have been through tremendous, tremendous challenges over the years. And this is just the latest one. I just, as some of you already know, several days ago, very unexpectedly and tragically, was in my hotel room. I'm on the road full-time for the past 3.5 years for the Lord and ministry. And my beloved handicapped dog, Mr. Simeon, died right in front of me late on a Saturday night. And he was truly one of the greatest blessings I've ever been given on this earth. We had an amazing, amazing bond. He was 100% dependent on me. He had a phenomenal love for me. He loved me and focused on me and longed for me and my attention and company and help and support and everything he needed. Food, water, going to the restroom, anything and everything he needed, he looked to me. He would literally watch me with his eyes, follow me around. That was actually the very last thing he did, is he just lifted up his neck and he looked around until he found me. And this, my friend, is the way we are to look to the Lord, with longing, with trust, with dependence, with faith, with thanksgiving, with a desire to be in His company moment by moment in His presence. And here I am now going through this loss. It was, I could never tell you how hard it has been. And he's also been part of my little family of Handicapped Streets Ministry dogs. He did amazing work out on the streets of the United States of America. The Lord used him and my other paralyzed wheelchair dog, Miss Mercy, countless times to open up people's hearts and to draw them over to me, to talk to me, at which time I was able to talk to them about Jesus, give them gospel tracts, pray for them, minister them, share the gospel, etc. And here I am going through this loss, and the Lord brings to my remembrance that those of us who have received Jesus Christ as Lord and made that true, genuine commitment to live for Jesus according to His ways and no longer according to the world's ways, we have the promise of God being with us forever and ever, and us with Him forever and ever and ever. And that is the comfort He gave me just now. I'm actually in my car about to take the remaining 3 Handicapped Streets Ministry dogs over to the veterinarian's office. And it is just amazing to me that even in the midst of just unbelievable sorrow, I have just such a strong presence and sense of the love, mercy, grace, peace, hope, joy, and company, friendship, fellowship, and lordship of the Lord Jesus Christ. God in the Bible is called the God of all comfort, and the Bible explains that He comforts us, that we may then in turn comfort others. And I've already had opportunities for years now, and even in days past, to be out there loving and comforting others and talking to them about Jesus. I could not encourage you more, friend, to give your life totally to Christ, to turn from your sins, believe in Him and His death and resurrection, believe in Him as Lord, receive the promise of everlasting life with Him, receive His forgiveness, receive the Holy Spirit who will come to live inside of you when you receive God, when you receive Jesus as Lord, and then go forward living totally, totally sold out for Jesus. I believe the reason that God took away my beloved dog at this time is to make me more and more free to go out across this country and via the internet and my writing and video devotionals across the world, to continue to tell people that Jesus Christ, as he himself said, he said, I am the way, the truth, the life. The only way to the Father is through Jesus, my friend. The only way to everlasting life is through Christ, through repenting, through believing in him as Lord, through living for him as Lord. Please visit me and Good News Ministry online at goodnews.love. And I sure would appreciate your prayers. I'm not giving up. Let me tell you something. I could call it quits in a heartbeat because I'm hurting so much. But instead, I want to use every breath I have left on this earth to love, worship, glorify God, and tell the world about the Lord Jesus Christ. Again, it's Lara Love and Good News Ministry. And you can see photographs of my beloved wheelchair doggy, Mr. Simeon, as well as Miss Mercy and the others, and sign up for my Good News Daily devotional writing and video devotionals at goodnews.love. Thank you.